Well, how's everybody this morning? Amen. Y'all glad to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Well, I hope all is well. I hope everybody watching through that camera is doing well today. If not, his name is Jesus, and we can make it well. Amen? I tell you what, if you will, turn to Judges chapter 16. Judges chapter 16. We're going to talk about Samson and Delilah today. Not something that you hear about all the time, but we're going to talk about it. I said, good to see you here this morning. Good to have you watching through that camera. Let's open up and have a word of prayer. Our precious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity of coming into your house. Lord, I just thank you for each and everyone that's here this morning. Lord, I thank you for those that are watching through that camera. Lord, I thank you for going into their heart this morning. Lord, anointing your word to be bigger than anything else in their life today and in days to come. Lord, I just thank you right now for allowing me this morning to be your mouthpiece. I thank you that your word never quits, it never fails, and it never gives up. And Lord, I just thank you right now for your love, your grace, and your mercy that you've shown upon all of us. Lord, I just thank you right now. It's in your precious name we pray. Amen. All right, we're going to pick up at verse number 15, but I'm going to kind of lay a little groundwork here before we get started, because we got a good bit to go to read it all. I don't think if we started at verse 1 where we really needed to start, we would get there. But Delilah has come up against Samson. You know, Samson, he's defeated a lot of the armies that's come out against other people. Right? If you will, he's the big man. They figure if we can take him down, we can be in control. Right? So Delilah and the Philistines, they devise a plan to kill Samson. Right? The only trouble with that is that Samson has got a different plan. So he's got the power of God on the inside of him. And they keep trying to defeat him. And it rocks on, and Delilah makes like she falls in love with him. And he falls in love with her. And she goes to him many times and says, if you love me, you'll tell me where you get your strength from. And of course, he'll tell her and it'll be a lie. You know, if you put green braids around me, that's never been dried, I can't break them, I don't have any strength. So she waits till he goes to sleep and they wrap him up and she yells, the Philistines is upon us. And he jumps up and he goes to whooping Philistines, amen? He cleans the house out, right? So he does this five or six times, just telling her all different kind of things. Tells her, if you braid my hair, the seven locks of my hair, if you braid my hair, that'll take away my strength. They try it again, and that don't take away his strength either. So then she tells him, you say that you love me, but you don't really love me. Because if you really loved me, you'd tell me the truth. Amen? Well, look at this as the anointing of the Lord that's on your life. Do you want to know why the Lord don't tell you everything that's going on in your life every minute of every day? We'd be just like Samson. We'd give in and we'd tell everything that we knew. Right? The Lord's not hiding this from us. He's hiding it for us. Right? That's why he don't open up his whole plan to us. A lot of times from the beginning, if we seen where we were going from here, we look and say, man, I can't do that. I'm not big enough to do that. Amen? See, we have to grow day by day through his word, through his anointing, through his patience, right? Because guess what happens when you start doing something? You're going to mess up, right? Anybody in here, you ever done something perfect the first time? No, it just don't happen, does it? Amen? I mean, you have to work at it, right? The first time you started writing the alphabet as a small child, did you get it right the first time? You knew every letter, had it perfect the first time. Nobody. Right? We're just not that way. Amen? So we're going to mess up. And we need the Lord to pick us up where we can keep going. Right? Mistakes, if you learn from them, build what? Character. Right? They build you and mold you and make you into the person that you are. right? Today, the stuff that you've been through in life has made you who you are, right? I mean, just think, and I think back in my life, if I'd have done some things different, how much different would my life be today? Right? If you'd have done something different, just one, how different would your life be today? Right? See, the Lord, He didn't plan that. He gave us choices, and we made them. He didn't make the choices. Right? So the optimal thing that the Lord's in control of you is hogwash, if you will. It's not, okay? He gave us choices to make. Right? Every day we all have a choice to make. Right? That's why it's so important that we spend time with Him to know, because sometimes you make a choice and you think that's the right way to go. But then you find out, man, I went the wrong way. Amen? See, if we'd have just inquired, and I'm not knocking anybody, I'm talking about myself. If I'd have just inquired, I'd have found out maybe I shouldn't have done that. Amen? Maybe I should have took a different path. Right? Maybe I should have done this just a little bit different. Or maybe I should have went this way. But maybe I should have done something else when I went that way. Right? See, that's called hearing His voice. That's putting His anointing out there and following it. Right? Not following, well, I think it'll be okay. Right? In my experience, in my life, most of the time, when I didn't know what to do, following everybody else wasn't the way the Lord wanted to go. Most of the time, He was going different than everybody else. Right? Most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time, if you find yourself following the crowd, you're going the wrong way. Amen? Most of the time. We ought to be in this Word. We ought to be spending time with Him. Right? Because if we don't, things slip up on us. And they don't physically or verbally say, if you love me, you'll tell me what you know. No, we just get in a bind. And we got to tell somebody, right? Amen? Amen? You know, I remember my Papa Brown. I was a little old bitty boy when he passed. But I remember one thing that he told me. He called me over and I'm going to tell you a secret. And he told me, he let me smoke a cigar, a little bit of a cigar. He said, you can't tell nobody. Can't tell nobody now. I seen him, I wasn't smoking, I just had it in my mouth. But I was a big wheel, right? Got to smoke a cigar. Amen? What you think the first thing done when my mom and daddy come in the house, what you think the first thing I done? I told them. My mama didn't like that. Amen? She didn't like that at all. Right? Everybody got mad at Papa. Everybody. And he told me, he said, you know, I believe it's true now. I finally figured it out. And I said, what's that, Papa? And he said, well, the only way two people can keep a secret is if one of them's dead. Amen? So if two people know something, somebody gonna tell it. Amen? That's what he was saying. You my buddy, and I thought you had my back. I thought you could take care of it. And you told on me. Right? Now, he wasn't being ugly, but he was being honest. Right? If the Lord tells us too much, if the Lord was to show us too much too soon, would it help us or would it hurt us? Most of the time, it would hinder us, right? Everybody wants the Lord to give them something mighty to do right now. But most of the time, the Lord don't work that way. The Lord wants you to take care of the small stuff first. Right? He said, if you be faithful over a few things, just a few, then I'll make you ruler over many. Not if you be faithful over a lot, I'll make you ruler over a little. It's not what the Lord said. Amen? So we have to learn to trust Him. We have to learn that anointing. Right? How many of us, if we had power today, if the Lord had given us power, and we knew what that power was, our strength was, how many of us would tell it? How many of us would tell it? Under the right situations, the right circumstances, how many of us would tell it? Every single one of us. right? So I'm not talking about Samson. I'd probably give me before he did, right? But see, he had the anointing of God on the inside of him. He had a power. Amen? Let me tell you something this morning. You got anointing of God on the inside of you. You got the power of Almighty God on the inside of you. Right? And it's not up to him what you do with it. It's up to you what you do with it. Right? But he's only going to give it to you most of the time, one step at a time. All of us have to grow. Amen? Amen? You know my grandbaby, a little over 2 years old. She's eating steak now. But you know what? When she was a newborn, we wouldn't give her steak. She had to grow into that, right? The Lord's the same way. You have to grow. You have to learn who you are. You have to find Him. Amen? But Delilah, she wouldn't quit. She wouldn't give up. She was persistent. Amen? Amen? If you love me. If you love me. Well, you know what? I got something for you. The Lord said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Right? Now, you want to talk about love, let's talk about His love. Right? They said, if you had to call God, if He had to be one word, what would it be? What would it be? He said, love. He said, God is love. Not He's loving, not He tries to love. It said He is love. Right? That's just who He is. Amen? But let's skip to verse 15 for time. And talking about Delilah. And she said unto him, how canst thou say, I love thee, when thy heart is not with me? Thou hast mocked me these three times, and hast not told me whether thy great strength lieth. And it came to pass, when she pressed him daily with her words, and urged him, so that his soul was vexed unto death. That's evil coming out, folks. Vexed unto death is evil. Right? Amen? Do you know what's in this world going after you? It's evil. Amen? Verse number 17. That he told her all his heart and said unto her, There hath not come a razor upon my head, for I have been a Nazareth unto God from my mother's womb. If I be shaven, then my strength will go from me, and I shall become weak and be like any other man. Right? So he's done told all his heart. It took a long time, but he finally fell in the trap. My point is, folks, the devil, he's not going to come at you just a few times and quit. The devil's going to be persistent. Amen? Every day you're going to have to stand on the Word of God. Every day you're going to have to know what you believe and why you believe it. Right? Every day you're going to have a course set. This is the way I'm going. Right? Amen? Because see, the first time that you put your guard down, right? Amen? As everybody tells me, you know, I just want to go home and sit down and just let my hair down. Well, when you go home and you sit down and you let your hair down and you get off guard, that's when you get in trouble. Amen? We can't do that. Not even for just a minute, folks. Not even for just a minute. We can't stoop down. We can't be on the level that the whole world is and think that the Lord is going to use us and bless us like His people. It's just not going to happen. Amen? Amen? The Lord loves all of us. He loves the sinner. You know what? He wants to do good to everybody. Right? Amen? But let's just go back to what I was saying earlier. What if every one of us knew the first time we became born again what we was going to be doing in the kingdom of heaven? What would we do? Some people still hadn't found their place. Amen? But I can tell you what would have happened. If I had known the first time I come in this building that the Lord was going to ask me to teach Sunday school, I wouldn't have come back. You know why? I knew I couldn't do that. Do you hear me? I couldn't do it. And Brother Bruce talks about how shy he was. I believe I was worse than that. I mean, I wouldn't even do a Christmas parade. I mean, a Christmas show. I'm talking about without lines, I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't even just stand there. You know, most people get uptight when they have a line. Well, they knew I wasn't going to say anything, so I was just going to stand there. And I said, oh, no, I'm not doing that. Oh, you can do it. I'm not going to do it. Amen? And Miss Tammy, I didn't do it. Right? I mean, I didn't have to do it, but that's my point. If the Lord had showed me that the day that I come in this building, I'd have said, I can't do that. But I had to grow. Right? I had to learn to trust Him. Right? That's what the Lord wants you to do today. He just wants you to trust Him. Right? When He brought the people out of bondage out of Egypt, you know what the Lord wanted to do? He just wanted the people to trust Him. He said He could take them in what was it, 11 days? 11 days He could have led them into the promised land. But He couldn't do it. He knew, if I take them there, they're not going in. Right? They're going to get overrun, things are going to happen, and there's going to be a problem. Right? So He led them the long way. All the way, giving them a fire by night to keep them warm, and a cloud by day to keep them cool. Had manna and water following them, going with them. Amen? And all I had to do was trust Him. All I had to do was trust Him. Right? What have we got to do, folks? Trust Him. That's all we got to do, is just trust Him. We don't have to know the outcome. We don't have to know how many people is going to be mad at us at the end of the day. Right? You know, I hate to say this, but this is the truth. If you're never getting on anybody's toes, you must not be doing something right. Right? Because the Word of God ought to be different in us. It ought to be making changes in us that the rest of the world don't have. Right? If we find ourselves looking just like the world and acting like the world, I would say there's a very strong possibility there's something wrong, wouldn't you? Amen? Because remember, He said, be ye transformed from this world by the renewing of your mind through and by the Word of God. Right? Right? What changes us? What points our direction? It's faith, ain't it? Faith is going to make you do something. You're going to have to believe I can do this or I can overcome this, or you're not going to attempt to do it. Right? Amen. How many people would walk across the top of this building up here this morning? I can tell you now, I'm not doing it. I don't have that kind of faith. I'm not strong enough to believe I can do it. But you know what? There's people that can. They don't even think about it. Right? They've proven they know who they are. Right? Have we? And I'm talking about worldly things right there. But in the Word of God, have we proven who we are? Do we know without a shadow of a doubt who I am? Every single one of us should. Amen? Every single one of us should. But that's not what I ask you. I said, do we? Amen? And I'm not getting on our toes, and the Lord's not getting on our toes. But He's just saying, don't get too antsy. Don't get too ahead of me. Stay with me. Amen? Take this one step at a time. Just one step. Amen? Lord's not asking you to learn all of this in one day. Right? He's not asking you to hear this one time and be perfect. He's asking you to continue to come back. He's asking you to continue to be in His Word. Continue to spend time with Him. Amen? Because just as Emerson is growing, we have to grow in the Lord.
Right.
Amen? Let's see. I think I was at verse number 17. He said that He told her all His heart and said unto her, there hath not come a razor upon my head, for I have been a Nazareth unto God from my mother's womb. He said, if I be shaven, then my strength will go from me, and I shall become weak and be like any other man. And Delilah saw that he had told her all his heart. So she sent and called for the lords of the Philistines, saying, come up this once, for he hath showed me all his heart. Then the lords of the Philistine came up unto her and brought money in their hand. Right? It's amazing every time we see somebody getting betrayed. It's usually always for money, ain't it? Usually always for money. You know what? Most of the time when you see somebody doing something wrong in the world today, what's the root of the problem? They doing it for money, aren't they? Right? You see somebody lying. You see somebody doing this. You see somebody doing that. What's it about? It's about money. It's about money. Folks, I hate to tell you, but all our politicians, it's not about the service. It's not about the job. It's about the money. It's about the money. Amen? Amen? I mean, when you go in and you don't even have anywhere to live, and you come out and you got 7 mansions, something's wrong. Something is wrong. Amen? He didn't say money was the root of all evil. He said the love of money. Right? The love of money will make you turn on people. The love of money will make you do a lot of things. Amen? And you know what I figured out? You don't have to have $1 million to have the love of money. You cannot have a penny in your pocket and have the love for money. Just constantly going after it. You know how I know? I was that person. I was that person. I didn't have a dime to my name, but I thought, I got to have it. I got to have it. Hey, if you don't have it, you're going to run out. Right? You're going to run out. I'm here to tell you today, the Lord won't let you run out. If you'll trust Him, if you'll get in His covenant, the Lord won't let you run out. But you know what? It took me time to figure that out. I had to grow in that. And in that time, all those mistakes I made, the Lord didn't throw me away. He didn't quit on me. He didn't get mad at me and say, well, you made your bed, lay in it. Nobody ever heard that before, have they? You made your bed, you lay in it now. I mean, I hadn't heard it lately. It'd probably be racist to say that now. Made your bed, you lay in it. Amen? But the truth is, excuse me, the Word of God, it never quits, it never fails, and neither does He. Not even, folks, if we make a mistake. Not even if we miss it. Right? Right? It's not about how many times a just man falls. It's how many times that just man gets back up. Amen? Because see, as long as you keep getting back up, you still got fight, you still got a chance. But when you go down and you stay, then it's over. Then it's over. Amen? Verse number 19. And she made him sleep upon her knee, and she called for a man. And she caused him to shave off the 7 locks of his head, and she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him. And she said, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he awoke out of his sleep and said, I will go out as other times before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. He didn't even realize that the Lord was gone. He didn't even realize that anointing wasn't there. My, my, my. How many times have we been in that situation? We think the Lord's right there with us, and the whole time we're going the wrong way right by ourselves. Amen? Verse number 21. But the Philistines took him and poked his eyes out and brought him down to Gaza and bound him with fetters and brass, and he did grind in the prison house. He could have just died right there, couldn't he? In the prison house. Verse number 23. Verse 22, let's just stay on. He said, howbeit the hair of his head began to grow again after he was shaven. Then the Lord of the Philistines gathered them together for to offer a great sacrifice unto Dagon, their god, and to rejoice, for they said, our God hath delivered Samson, our enemy, into our hands. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, our God hath delivered him into our hands, enemy, and the destroyer of the country, which slew many of us. And it came to pass, when their hearts were merry, that they said, call for Samson, that he may make us sport. They wanted to make fun of him. They wanted to poke at him. Right? They wanted to talk about him. They wanted to parade him around and say, look right here. This is a man that's defeated all these Philistines. This one man. But he's not in control anymore. Right? We in control now. Now we have him. Now we're going to show you what we do to people like him. Right? Today they'd call it making an example, wouldn't it? Yeah. Amen? And it came to pass when their hearts were merry that they said, call for Samson, that he may make us sport. And they called for Samson out of the prison house, and he made them sport. And they set him between the pillars. And Samson said unto the lad that held him by the hand, suffer me that I may feel the pillars whereupon the house standeth, and that I may lean upon them. Verse number 27. Now the house was full of men and women, and all of the lords of the Philistines were there. And there were upon the roof about 3,000 men and women that held while Samson made sport. And Samson called unto the Lord and said, O Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once, O God, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes. He prayed unto the Lord, and he didn't ask to be set free. He asked for strength. He knew he'd messed up, didn't he? He knew. I had all of that anointing. I had all that power. And I played with it. I done nothing with it. Amen? And when it come right down to it, it hurt him that he had that. How about me and you? How much of the anointing of God do we have that we're not using? Amen. Verse number 29. And Samson took hold of the two middle pillars upon which the house stood and on which it was bore upon, and the one with his hand and the other with his left hand. And Samson said, let me die with the Philistines. And he bowed himself with all his might, and the house fell upon the lords and upon all the people that were there. So the dead which slew in his death were more than they which he slew in his life. Right? Amen? Even when it looked like it was over. Even when the enemy had him bound. Even when the enemy made fun of him. There was still fight left in Samson. How much fight's left in you this morning? You that are watching through that camera, how much fight is left in you? Amen. You know, I've heard this for a long time, and it took a while for me to figure out what they was talking about, but I figured it out. They said it's not about the size of the dog in the fight. It's about the size of the fight in the dog. Amen. It's not time to quit, folks. It's not time to give up. It's time to get in this word more than you have ever been in it before. It's time to go after God. It's time to seek Him more than you've ever sought Him in your life. Amen? I'm not trying to prophesy bad things. I'm not trying to prophesy evil. But I'm telling you, not that it's coming. It's here, folks. It's here. It's not coming anymore. It's here. It's here. And it's up to me and you. Right? It's up to us. Right? Can you trust Him today? You know, right now we're still fairly free in the United States of America. Fairly. There's still quite a few things that we can't do. But all in all, we're still fairly free. If we can't trust Him right now, how will we ever trust Him when he gets to that point. And folks, he said that point was coming. He said that day was coming. Is it going to be in mine in your lifetime? I can't tell you that. I honestly believe with all of my heart that it is. I honestly do. I honestly do. But whether it does or not, as the pastor said, one thing is for sure. He's coming for you in your life. One day you're going to breathe your last breath. One day I'm going to breathe my last breath. Then what? Right? Then what? It's over then, ain't it? It is on this earth, but you know what? He said, then the judgment. We hear a lot about grace and mercy, and I need it. I need it more than anybody does. But what about the judgment? Nobody wants to talk about the judgment, do they? Everybody wants to talk about the good things. Everybody wants to talk about the love of God. Everybody wants to talk about prosperity. Nobody wants to talk about the judgment. Folks, judgment's coming. The Lord said it was, and it is. Amen? Let's be prepared. Let's make sure we're walking in His footsteps every step of every day. Amen? He's the only way we're going to make it. Do you hear me? He is the only way we're going to make it. I'm telling you, you're not going to make it on your own. Can't happen. Right? But with Him, all things are possible to him that believeth. Amen? That believeth. Not that quit, not that give up. Amen? Winners never quit, and quitters never win. Amen? So today, if you hadn't found your part, if you hadn't figured out what am I supposed to be doing today, and there's a lot of folks that hadn't, you figure out, you spend time with the Lord and figure out what am I supposed to do. Amen? All of us are supposed to do something, folks. Right? But find out what you're supposed to do. Start in the direction to find out who am I and what am I supposed to do. Right? Amen? Because remember, the person that plans to go nowhere, he always gets there. That's right. The person that never sets any goal, they always make them. Right? Let's set goals. Let's go after the Word of God. Amen? Is His Word true? Can we trust Him this morning? I'm closing, but can we trust Him this morning? Amen? Well, let's pour our heart into it. All of this other stuff that's in the world is nothing but stuff. Amen? I'm not knocking stuff. I like stuff. Everybody likes stuff. But if stuff is coming between you and the Word of God, get rid of it. Amen? Get rid of it. Because it's hurting you more than it's helping you. Amen? I'm not knocking anybody, but you know, I know people today that are fairly well off. And they working today. They working today. And you know what? It's not because they can't pay their bills. They working because they're trying to get the next newest thing that comes out. Got to have it. And I'm not knocking you. I've been that way before. But the last new thing you got you, how long did it please you? How long did it satisfy you? Till something else new come out, didn't it? Then you had to have that. You know what? When you get whatever you're going after today, tomorrow something else you're going to want. It's going to be never ending. Amen? Be content with stuff and go after Him. Amen? He is the answer. Amen? You want to see your life turned upside down? His name is Jesus. You want to see this city we live in turned upside down? His name is Jesus. The state, the country, the world. It's only limited to us, folks, as to what we do with it. Right? Amen? I love you this morning. I appreciate you being here. I hope you got something out of that. Man, the Lord really, most people can't comprehend His love. And because we've used love, the word love, so often and so many times that it really don't have a whole lot of meaning. Amen? But love with action, not love with words. Amen? It's not time to quit. It's time to dig in, folks. It's time to grab hold of this word harder and more than you've ever done it in your life. Amen? Your enemy, the devil, he's here. Amen? Once again, I love you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for the watching through that camera. Let's have a closing prayer. Our precious Heavenly Father, we thank You, Lord, for this opportunity once again for coming into Your house. Lord, I thank You for Your word that You give us. Lord, I thank You that we continue to walk in it. Lord, we continue to grow in it day by day. Lord, I just thank You right now for Your love, Your mercy, Your long-suffering, Your patience. Lord, I just thank You for it right now. It's in Your precious name we pray. Amen. Be back here at 10:45. Brother Bruce Brown will be here. He'll have the Word of God. He'll have the truth. Amen? Amen? God bless you. God bless America. Amen?